Our first presenter, I will bring out Souransu, Nandi. Well, thank you very much. His department is Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering. His hometown is Kolkata, India. His future career plans, wishes to be a full-time researcher to work on engineering problems that can have a large impact on society. And his presentation deals with diabetes and the treatment of diabetes. So if you are ready, ready, set, pitch.
In the next 24 hours, 206 Americans will be diagnosed with type 1 diabetes. That means someone, a man, woman, or child, will get sobering, life-changing news every 7 minutes. And these numbers are predicted to get three times as worse in the next 20 years. So it is imperative we find some solutions. So what happens in type 1 diabetes? The pancreas in type 1 diabetic patients loses its ability to make the hormone insulin. Left untreated, the blood glucose level dangerously rises, eventually leading to nerve damage, kidney failure, and blindness. The primary method of treatment, which has actually remained the same for almost 100 years, involves patients injecting themselves with insulin every single day. Moreover, as a patient, you always have to watch what you eat, when you eat, or what you do, and your day largely revolves around managing the disease, greatly restricting your quality of life. So can we do something to resolve this? It is only in the past decade that engineers have developed a wearable device called the artificial pancreas to make treatment easier. The artificial pancreas continuously senses your blood glucose level, uses this information to determine the necessary insulin required, and then delivers this insulin into the body from an external reservoir without the patient having to do anything on their own. Now, my research is to develop algorithms for the computer chips on these devices so that the artificial pancreas can closely mimic the actions of a natural pancreas. So the way these algorithms work is that at the core, I write a set of equations which is capable of predicting what the glucose level will be at a future time instant. And based on that, I can suggest an insulin amount now. However, the biggest challenge here is to deal with uncertainties in human behavior and physiology. For example, how my body reacts to, say, a pumpkin spice latte is different from how someone else's body does, because our metabolism rates are different, or you could have just returned from a run. Moreover, glucose concentrations also depend on how stressed we are or how much we eat, and these factors are always uncertain. So when I write my algorithms, I have to use principles in probability to account for all these uncertainties. Now imagine a day in the future when you walk into a doctor's office and are diagnosed with type 1. The doctor gives you a bionic device, you attach it to yourself, and that's it. You forget about it. You carry on living a normal life. You drink beer, you play sports, and you can even eat an unplanned donut. My research has convinced me that we are not far from that day. Thank you.
Brilliant. Thank you, Mr. Nandi. And I mean this, even though I only have a bachelor's, I understood everything you said. Great job.